us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God,
our heavenly God, we have sinned against you and against our God, in the thoughts of the power of our humanity, your negligence, your weakness, our power of your thoughts, your heart of sorrow, and your head of all our sins. For the sake of our Son, Jesus Christ, our God, forgive us all our trespasses, and grant us the grace.
first excellent gift of love, the true bond of peace and of all virtues, without which whoever lives is counted dead before you. Grant this for your only Son, Jesus Christ's sake, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
Reading from the second book of Kings. When the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way to Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives, and as the Lord himself lives, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went, and stood at some distance from them, as they were both standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted to the one side and to the other until the two of them crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elisha said, "Please let me inherit a double share of your spirit." He responded, "You have asked a hard thing. Yet if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted you. If not, it will not." As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them, and Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, "Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." But when he could no longer see them, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces, picked up the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him, and went back and stood on the bank of the Jordan. He took the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him and struck the water, saying, "Where is the God of Elijah?" When he had struck the water was parted to the one side and to the other, and Elisha went over. This is the word of God. Fornication, impurity,
crucify the flesh with its passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us also be guided by the Spirit. This is the word of the Lord.
No one who puts a hand to the plough and looks back is
fit for the kingdom of God. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
I speak to you in the name of God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let me take you back, if I may, to our first reading, which Andrew read to us, from the second book of the Kings, chapter 2, verse 6. Elisha cried out, my father, the chariots and horsemen of Israel. Wow, what an exit that was for Elijah. I hope you noticed it's one of the most dramatic passages in the Bible. Elijah was literally whirled up to heaven, and it could hardly have been more dramatic and memorable. The chariots and horsemen of Israel, along with that whirlwind in which Elijah was whisked into the heavenly places in great style, they were more than merely a rather melodramatic exit strategy. All the dramatic effects firmly convinced Elisha, as Elijah's nominated successor, that there was serious work for him to do. And Elisha would have remembered Elijah's departure for the rest of his life. That's what happens when you're part of a dramatic event like that. More important than him just remembering it, it would have inspired him to carry on Elijah's work. So, let's pause to ask for a moment, what was Elijah's work? I'll tell you, in a nutshell, Elijah's work was to demonstrate very clearly, beyond any manner of doubt, that God, the God of Israel, was not one to be messed with. You find it again and again as you go through the stories of Elijah. The strength, the power of God is questioned. And Elijah demonstrates that they must take God, Yahweh, El Shaddai, seriously. And go back, if you will, just a few moments to our gospel story, which Roger read for us. At the very beginning of our gospel reading, St. Luke implies, I'd like to suggest to you, a parallel between Elijah and Jesus. That is, Jesus, like Elijah, was to be taken up. John's Gospel, indeed, shows very, very clearly that first Jesus was lifted up on the cross. Then he was taken up in the ascension. Now, I wonder if you can make the connection. That is, the ascension is the equivalent of the dramatic impact of the chariots and horsemen of Israel. But where and who is the parallel for Elisha? It's here. It's here. It's you and me and many others. We are challenged by the death, resurrection, and ascension of Jesus to do as Elisha did for Elijah, and to carry on Jesus' work of self-emptying, redeeming love. But, in terms of this story, there's a difficulty. Namely, you and I were not there in person with Jesus, were we, to be be, as his first disciples were, forever inspired by his death, resurrection, and ascension. We weren't there. Absolutely right, we weren't. It was more than 2,000 years ago. And that is why the Mass, our weekly or daily Eucharistic feast of thanksgiving, represents for us, before our very eyes, and with us as participants, not as observers, these cosmos-changing events. For Elisha, the cosmos was shown to be changed from how it had been thought to be, when Elijah, in that amazing one-off exit strategy, was whisked up with the chariots of horsemen, the chariots and horsemen of Israel. Let there be no doubt that after that, for Elisha, El Shaddai, the Lord God, the Almighty, reigns. And so it can be for us. As we do, as we shall indeed do at the moment in a few moments, and as we do each Sunday, some weekdays, as we reenact at the altar, as the priestly and prophetic people of God, Jesus' self-sacrifice of love for the whole world, as we do that, so we are to be in no doubt that the God who reigns in the meekness of his majesty is Jesus, who was crucified, who shed his blood for us. Jesus, who was crucified and is risen, bids us each as a contemporary Elisha, continue his work, as Elisha continued the work in Elijah. And I sense that you know how we must do that, in the same way as Elisha knew how he must follow Elijah. You see, Elisha did not lack the knowledge of what to do. No, he lacked the courage and the resilience to do it. And that, I suggest to you, is really quite close to where we are. We know full well in our hearts that we are made for self-giving love. Yeah? You speak to the average person, they know it. We know in our hearts that we are made for self-giving love, but we don't, as they say, have the bottle, as they say, to deliver on what we know we are made. Indeed, it is our common human experience that St. Paul was telling it how it is when he wrote to Romans, the good that I would, I do not, and the evil that I would not, that I do. He'd got it in one, hadn't he? That's where we are. Not just us, the rest of the whole human race as well. It's where we are. But mark me well, if you will, it doesn't have to be, it shouldn't be, God doesn't want it to be, where we will be. Each Mass, each day, each moment of our lives, let us recommit ourselves through penitence, mutual forgiveness, prayer, and the sacraments to allowing the Christ to shine through. God will do the rest. And you know, he has shown that he is well capable. Trust him then. Trust him then. And let's live his love in the power of the Spirit and to the glory of God the Father. May it be so. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
We continue to hold in our prayers the people of Ukraine, those who awake daily to fighting and violence, to the devastation of their land, their homes, their businesses. Pray listen for those who are part of the Russian forces. Hold in our prayers those thousands of largely women and children who have escaped across the borders of Ukraine, seeking refuge and safety. And we pray that they may be welcomed here in this country and in other countries. Lord, in your mercy, we pray with deep thanksgiving for Elizabeth, our Queen. We give thanks for her 70 years of dedicated service as monarch. We pray for strength, for graciousness, and for continued delight in life. Pray for her and for close members of her family. Pray also for those who manage the affairs of her government. Pray for our Prime Minister and Ministers of State. For our local members of Parliament, Connor Burns, Mr. Tobias Oldham. And for those who represent us in local government, particularly Hazel Allen and Michael Green. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for all who work in our hospitals, remembering particularly the chaplaincy at Bournemouth Hospital, Duncan Bridger, the lead chaplain, and all members of the team. Lord, in your mercy. Pray for this diocese of Winchester, particularly for members of the vacancy and see committee, charged with the responsibility of finding who is the person who fulfills God's will to be the next bishop of Winchester. And pray for our bishops as they carry forward the work of this diocese, for Bishop Debbie, Bishop David. And we give thanks to God for the assistance of Bishop Richard. Pray also for Michael Smith, our area dean. Lord, in your mercy. We remember those who are preparing for ordination as priest and deacon. Especially we lift in our prayers before God Rob Sordi from this parish as he prepares to be made deacon by Bishop Debbie in our cathedral next Sunday. We also pray for Bishop Stephen of Salisbury as he begins his episcopal ministry there. Pray that he and his family may be happy and settled, and that his ministry may be richly blessed in the diocese of Salisbury. Lord, in your mercy. We remember before God those who we know are sick, or housebound, or in hospital. Amongst them, Joe Hollis, Ray Farley, Mary Dunn, Malcolm Warwick, Charles Claxton. And others known to us. Lord, in your mercy. And we rejoice before God that our loved ones who have died now enjoy the vision of glories into all eternity. And we give thanks particularly for those whose years mind fall at this time. Amongst them, David Maddox, priest, Graham Wheeler, priest, and Leslie Murgatroyd. And amongst those who have died recently, we commend into the hands of God, Father Joseph. May they rest in peace.
And rest in peace.
Merciful Father,
accept
peace of our crucified, risen, ascended Lord, we always
peace of God.